Hello and welcome to Current Issues with me, Tarun. Today, we are going to discuss the rising incidents of cyber crime in India. If we see the data of the past couple of years, cyber crime in the country has been rising by the year after year, and has caught many people who are new to technology, the older ones, the middle-aged ones, unaware, as also a lot of young ones who are not that technologically inclined. We discuss the issue threadbare today with Pawan Duggal. He's a social media and cyber expert. Then there is VK Suri, he's financial expert. He joins us in our studios in Noida. Dinesh Yadav, SP City Noida, too, joins us from the phone link. But first, let me go across to Dinesh Yadav. He's SP City, who also handles cyber crime in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. Dinesh Yadav, could you explain to us on what account are we seeing rising incidents of cyber crime in the country?
ऐसा है, अगर हम आपको पूरा सिनेरियो जो हमने यहाँ नोएडा में देखा है, उसके अलावा लखनऊ में देखा है, वो जिसमें सबसे अगर आपके 100 क्राइम रिपोर्ट होते हैं तो लगभग 50% फाइनेंशियल फ्रॉड्स के होते हैं, और जो सोशल मीडिया वायलेशंस का जो शेयर है वो लगभग 30% है, और शेष में ढेर जो और बचे हुए इंटरनेट वायलेशंस हैं जिनको साइबर क्राइम कहते हैं।
ओके तो ओपनिंग कमेंट के लिए वी आर गोइंग टू वीके सूरी। वीके सूरी, व्हाट वुड बी ओपनिंग कमेंट फॉर टुडेज डिबेट?
सी, माय कमेंट विल बी दैट पीपल शुड बी मोर अवेयर एंड दे शुड टेक केयर ऑफ their money, take care of the things themselves. Like if I give you key of my house, so where I am protecting myself?
Yes.
Similarly, people, they take very casual approach while managing their financial matters.
Yes.
They give out their details, they don't see, and they respond immediately to the SMS, immediately to the emails, lending into the
financial. So you personally should be very careful, is your opening comment.
That is the first point.
Dinesh Yadav, at this point, before I come back, Dinesh Yadav, there are some data that I have with me. I would like to read it out to you. I'll first begin with the incidents. In 2013, there were about 41,319 incidents of cybercrime in the country. This increased to 44,679 in 2014, and by 2015, it came to 49,455 cases. So year by year, as you can see this data before your screen, year after year, the incidents of cyber crime have been increasing. The complaints registered have been increasing. The number of people arrested also has grown from 3,300 to 8,121. As you can see, in Uttar Pradesh, cases registered and people arrested is 2208, Maharashtra is 2195825, and Karnataka cases registered 1447 and people arrested are 293. Rajasthan 49 cases, 295 people arrested, 687430 is Telangana. You see the age group of people arrested, 0 to 18 is 45, 18 to 30, 1638, 30, 45 is 1325, 45 to 60 is 275, 60 years and above only 18. Of course, this can be gauged from the fact that it's a young people are committing this crime more. So, I'll go to Dinesh Yadav and we'll get to know from him. Dinesh Yadav, if I may ask you, are you seeing that there is a propensity of cyber crimes happening more and more and increasing as we get digitally more advanced? I mean, due to digitization, do you think there is a bent for such crimes and you see this rising incident always now?
As you know,
yes,
when something is used,
yes,
it is also misused.
Okay.
Internet is being used day by day, the usage is dramatically increasing. So, the misuse of internet is also increasing. It's a normal phenomena.
Yes.
And one more thing I want to point out here is,
yes,
this cyber crime is not a urban phenomena. This is also happening in rural areas.
Okay.
When I was heading this cyber crime cell Lucknow, the cases from Kushinagar, Devaria, Behraich, Gonda, Jhansi, for है ना, एटीएम फ्रॉड, डेबिट कार्ड फ्रॉड, दे वर रिपोर्टेड फ्रॉम देयर आल्सो.
ओके, सो यू मीन
दिस इज नॉट
अर्बन, दिस इज नॉट एन अर्बन फिनोमेना
आल्सो. या या,
सो यू सेड दिस इज अ रूरल फिनोमेना आल्सो. सो कुड यू एक्सप्लेन टू अस एंड आल्सो आवर व्यूअर्स that see a lot of middle-aged people who are using internet for the first time in their lives, they don't know how to save themselves and they get into a trap. The younger ones, they say, are to some extent are better off. How could people save themselves from getting trapped? As somebody who does law enforcement, what is your advice to the people?
As you know, prevention is always better than cure.
Yes.
So awareness is the key of to basically prevent the persons from being the culprit of these crimes.
Okay.
So people, there should be a wide campaign for the cyber crime awareness, how to be safe online.
Okay.
And what precautions they should take when they are doing their financial transactions, when they are using social networking sites, whatever things or whatever they are doing on the internet,
yes,
that is being basically recorded and someone can follow it and they can commit crime.
Okay, I'll go to Pawan Duggal at this moment. He's an expert on cyber and social media. Pawan, could you explain to our viewers what is the reason for the rising incidence of cyber crime and who are the most susceptible people to who will be victims of cyber crime going forward?
Well, the reason is that today we find everybody is using the digital ecosystem. They're using mobiles. Consequently, because our dependence on the electronic format has become so predominant, it's but natural to expect that there are going to be increased incidences of cybercrimes. In fact, cybercriminals are pretty confident. They only want to focus on the direction where a majority of the people are focusing or are actually converging. So that's the reason why social media today really presents a very fertile ground as far as people who can be potential victims of cybercrime can be concerned. And the fact remains is that we have by and large as a nation not had the right kind of impetus in terms of getting cybercrime convictions. We have only single digit convictions of cybercrimes in the country. And the problem is that almost all cybercrimes can only be proved by relevant incriminating electronic evidence, which is going to be produced and proved in a court of law. And today in India, a majority of the people go ahead and first destroy the incriminating electronic evidence against their own selves, thereby making it even more difficult for people to be convicted for cybercrimes.
Okay.
So that's the reason why we are beginning to see a distinct scenario where cybercrime is increasing but convictions are very less.
Okay, I'm going to VK Suri at this moment. VK Suri, could you explain to our viewers, see what happens is when there is an incident of cybercrime, there is an increasing propensity of many people to be, you know, scared of digital technologies. Okay, we won't use the internet banking system because you don't know, you may get defrauded. Do you think there is any reason to fear? Because such incidents cause fear in the mind of few people.
See, the frauds will happen in any system.
Yes.
It is only that how we can get them reduced to the lowest level.
Yes.
So, unawareness should not be a issue of the fear that you don't know how to do it. Just very simple two steps I will tell you.
Yes.
And 50% of this problem can be resolved just while dealing with any financial matter electronically. You read the banks or any other financial institutions,
yes,
do's and don'ts.
Yes.
90% of the people don't read it. If you read that do's and don'ts.
So, you mean it is self-ignorance? You yourself,
yes,
don't want to read it?
Yes, you don't want, you are taking it very casually.
Okay.
If you read it,
yes,
then there are less chances that you will fall to any fraud.
Okay, that's a good point. I'm going to Dinesh Yadav at this point. Dinesh Yadav, could you explain to us and our viewers what kind of cyber crimes do you increasingly see, say in Noida also, which can be a representative of the country in Noida? What is a common kind of cyber crime? Is it debit card fraud or credit card fraud? What is the common thing that happens the most?
as I have said earlier,
yes,
the out of total crimes, around 50% are financial crimes.
Yes.
Out of financial crimes, the major portion in Noida is of job frauds, okay, lottery frauds, insurance frauds, like things. The petty or small call centers, they are calling people. They generally, what they do, what is their modus operandi is, they purchase data from Naukri.com.
Yes.
Or Times.com or Sign.com job portals. They'll take, right, what, 20,000 rupees for 1 month, 10,000 data. After that, when they have this data, in this data they have the customer's name or the person's name, their address, their mobile numbers, and their resume. Then they call a person and say, if a person is eligible for a job of 10,000 rupees, what they do, they offer him a job of 25,000 rupees. When you are expecting a job of 20,000 rupees and you are getting an offer of 25,000, you will be elated.
Yes.
Then they say that you have to deposit this much of money for your processing, your application.
Yes.
And they deposit the money happily.
Okay.
After that, they again ask the customers or the culprit, please deposit this much of money for the verification purposes.
Okay.
So they take two or three installments of around 50,000, 55,000 rupees. After that, they basically disconnect the contact from that customer.
Okay.
And he got cheated. And so, this is the process.
So could you do a large number?
The other
of
is lottery frauds.
Okay. Okay, please go on.
We have busted in last 1 year, we have busted around 60 call centers in Noida only.
60 call centers? That's huge.
Yes. Yeah.
So,
most of the offenders or criminals, they are not technically very sound persons. They are 12th pass persons.
Yes.
They have worked in some call center. They got the idea, how can we do it? And they started their own call centers and they did it.
Okay. So some very glaring facts pointed out by Dinesh Yadav, that how gullible people are, fall into a trap, pay money, don't even get jobs, but end up losing money. I've got a caller, Sagar, who's, so Sagar has to make a point. Sagar, can you hear me?
Yes.
Sagar, what point? Yes, please.
Yeah. So I'm watching your debate. So the solution to cybercrime, I believe, should not be an hindrance to the right of privacy, you know.
Yes.
We've seen this in US, wherein there was a clash between CIA and Apple. There was a denial to show the password. So I'm very still comfortable with the idea of state posing instructions for public,
yes,
showing that it is, you know, eradicating cyber crime.
Yes.
So stringent law should be made. But not at the cost, but not the personal data should not be encroached. So there should be fair amount of balance in that.
Okay, Sagar.
Privacy versus cybercrime.
Okay, I take your point, Sagar. Thanks so much for airing your view. We've got another caller online. Juhi, what point do you want to make?
Hi, I just wanted to ask a question, actually.
Yes.
I have an account on Facebook and somebody had been following me on Facebook and sending me, nonsense messages like I want to marry you and stuff.
Yes.
For a very long time.
Yes.
So I ignored it initially, and one fine day, when I learned to sort of block it, and when I had it on my smartphone,
okay,
then I blocked him. So very recently, like last month, I suddenly, bumped upon some pending requests on my Messenger, not Facebook. Now, because he's blocked on Facebook, but on my Messenger, saying, like dhamkiyon bhare messages the, like, you know, okay, you think you've blocked me on Facebook and I'm going to get go away. You're not going to get away with me like that so easily.
Okay.
And I know your address, I know your parents' address, you're going to repent and all.
Yes.
And also, he sent me the link of a woman who was recently murdered by one of these crazy lovers in Chennai.
Okay.
So, you know, hinting that, you know, this is what I'm going to do to you.
Okay.
So now I want to report this case with the cyber cell in Delhi or in UP. But I'm just a little skeptical about how it's going to be taken up. And,
okay,
you know, after police,
I think,
two din,
Julie, I'm going to pose this question to Dinesh Yadav. He's SP Noida. Maybe he can help you with this. Dinesh Yadav, you would have heard the question the girl from Gangtok asked. How would you respond to her? How would you respond to her?
Where she lives? Where she lives?
She is from Gangtok, northeast, Sikkim.
So she should go to the concerned police station.
Yes.
And she should register his complaint. The case will be registered and it will be investigated. It is not very difficult to trace him out.
Okay. At this point, I have V.K. Suri also with us in the studio. V.K. Suri wanted to make a point. Yes, V.K. Suri.
So the experience of the people in this regard is that when they approach the police,
yes,
they say that we are trying it, and the months pass off and they don't get any clue of that person. And if by chance he is caught,
yes,
our law is such a loose on this point that even if he is convicted, you see the figures where how many people have been convicted on these
so you mean that,
crimes.
That,
so the conviction is very low.
So
the maximum punishment
conviction
is only
a larger
3 years.
Point that they are raising that
only
there is
years.
No fear.
Strict law.
Okay.
Is required.
Before
heavy punishment is required.
Okay. Before I go to our another panelist, I will go to Vidhi, who's a caller calling us, and then I'll get Pawan Duggal to answer the question. Yes, Vidhi, what question do you want to ask?
I wanted to ask one thing. According to me, I just wanted to know, do the panelists, do they feel that, you know, the person, like the excessive of showing off on the internet, sharing each and every personal detail on the internet, even that is making a person vulnerable to cyber.
Okay, that's a very good point, Vidhi. I'm going to take it up with both Dinesh Yadav and Pawan Duggal. Pawan Duggal, the caller from Jaipur asked that, you know, sharing everything on the internet, you put out all the information and personal information on the net, and then you become a victim of cyber stalking. Do you think one should refrain from doing that?
Absolutely. The fact is that currently India and Indians are going through a new revolution.
Yes.
This is the great Indian vomiting revolution.
Okay.
Where Indians are vomiting all kinds of information about their personal, professional, social life.
Yes.
And in this context, it's always a good idea not to share your information on the internet, because you should have a policy of trying to share information on a need to know basis.
Okay.
Because if you're going to share all your information, that's ready-made fodder and ammunition for all potential cyber criminals to go ahead and target you. And you can't really blame anyone, because you yourself have given the lead.
And
if you are using Facebook and you are announcing to the world.
Okay, I'm going to Dinesh Yadav with the same question. Dinesh Yadav, the girl called from Jaipur, and she asked that, you know, because we tend to give all personal information on the internet, we become victims. Do you think, as somebody who enforces law, do you think that people should refrain from putting all information about themselves on the internet, or it is normal to do so in today's world?
Yes, absolutely it should be. And we always, in the campaign of a cyber MNS, we generally tell the people, please don't share personal information to unknown persons.
Okay.
Don't make unknown persons your friend.
Okay.
First you see, study. If a person is reliable and you known to him, then only be even friend on social media.
Okay.
Otherwise, you may be cheated afterwards.
So, befriending unknown people is one important point that Dinesh Yadav said. Juhi is calling again. Yes, Juhi, what point do you want to make?
Tarun, my question wasn't that. My question was that, there's a little mistake. I'm not from Northeast. I am calling from Noida itself.
Okay.
And I have been wanting to make a complaint, to file a complaint against this person in the cyber cell department. But I'm little hesitant because, you know, people have been telling me that if police ne usse do din, you know, dhamka bhamka ke wapas chhod diya, then he might just, you know, get back to you in a worse way.
Okay.
So I just want to know what is the best way possible to avoid any sort of animosity from that guy, and also to get rid of the problem.
Okay, point taken. I'll get Dinesh Yadav. To Dinesh Yadav, the caller stays in Noida. She says that if after 2 days the police releases the same person, he may come and attack me. So should I go to the police? How do you look at this?
I assure Juhi ji,
please
come to the Center for Cyber Crime Investigation, Sector 6, Noida. If she wants to be anonymous, she can be, we'll take care. And she wants to register the case, we'll register the case and we will investigate.
Okay.
She should not afraid of.
Okay, she should not be afraid. Here is your answer from Dinesh Yadav. Okay, I'll go to Pawan Duggal at this point. Pawan Duggal, I want to ask you one very important point that Dinesh Yadav raised. He said that there are call centers which were operating and gullible people were also sent job emails. So do you think people itself in India are also very gullible who can be, you know, maybe fleeced by, you know, promising jobs and they end up paying 50,000 rupees? You think it's mass education that is required?
It's absolutely correct that people in India continue to be gullible. In fact, we've actually come from a society where we land up trusting people intrinsically.
Yes.
So consequently, what we see on the internet, we presume the same is correct and therefore tend to rely upon it and take it as gospel truth. But nothing can be farther than the truth.
Okay.
In fact, what you see on the internet may not necessarily either be accurate or authentic. And it's here, I think, that there's a need for far more capacity building amongst all stakeholders. The reality is that there's so much of these online fake recruitment scams, fake awards that keep on coming in. And Indians somehow tend to get fired in their imagination the moment they're offered something which is either free or at a huge discount.
Okay, that's a good
and
point.
Therefore, I think we need to create more awareness.
I'm taking your point. I'm going to VK Suri
so that
at
they
this
themselves
moment.
Should be avoided.
Okay, VK Suri, you want to come in on this?
See, this poverty and the lack of the jobs.
Yes.
That has lured the people to such jobs, and all those people who are involved in it, they are taking benefit of their this poverty and lack of jobs, and they befool them, and they are easy culprit. They are easy prey for them. So that's how they have been operating it. More awareness. That if you are, I have not applied for a job and I am getting a call for the job.
Yes.
One should strike.
So, you mean it's basic common sense more than anything else?
Yeah, if somebody is calling you, go and search it. If you are doing it on the internet,
yes.
Search it. Where is that company exists?
Okay.
Is company ko kya hai? What they sell? What they
and
do?
Why are they offering me the
why
job?
Why they are offering you job? Ghar baith kar paisa kamaiye, pajame mein baith kar paisa kamaiye. Why all this?
Yeah. So, you mean it's simple common sense that can save a lot of frauds.
Right.
Okay, I'm going to Dinesh Yadav at this point. Dinesh Yadav, could you explain to the viewers two or three things that, first of all, how to, you know, maybe save yourself in from stalking, because cyber stalking is becoming very common in the country and people are hesitant to come and report it to the police, because as Juhi was scared, maybe there are many more people. What would be your message to a lot of these young people who are on the internet every day?
As far as social media networking sites are concerned,
yes.
First of all, we should not share our password to our friends also, and we should periodically change the password, and password should be set using alphabets, small letters, characters. So
yes.
Many combination as can be,
yes.
And it should be large enough. It should at least have 10-12 characters.
Yes.
This is one thing. The other thing is, you should not share any such information which can be utilized against you. So your privacy setting should be such that you share what you are sharing to whom you are sharing. You should know it.
Okay.
The other thing is, you should not share any personal information on public view.
Okay. I'm taking your point and we move to closing comments now. VK Suri, give me your closing.
And any financial permission.
Okay. Financial.
Financial information shall not be shared.
Okay. We got a caller named Surbi. Surbi, what question do you want to ask?
Don't make unknown persons your friends.
Okay. Surbi, what is your question?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
I'm Subish from Itawa, UP.
Yes.
And I just wanted to know that, as you know that in the UP, the number of cybercrime has increasing day by day.
Yes.
So, is there any option or is there any solution to stop that? What's the solution to stop that? Because I'm personally a victim of cybercrime.
Yes.
And now I'm seeing that in UP, the number is increasing day by day.
Okay.
UP is on the top rank.
Okay. So, this
what's the solution to stop
that? I will ask in the closing comments to Mr. Dinesh Yadav. But first, let me start from VK Suri. Give me your closing comments quickly as we're running out of time.
So, we need the stricter law
on
this ground so that we could catch hold of the criminals and give them the proper punishment, not that the 3 years.
Okay, so stricter law is your point.
And one very simple thing for the credit card and the ATM card holders, yes, that if you just CVC number, CVV number is the last three digits number on your credit card, you just scratch them and only remember them.
Okay, okay. Point taken. Pawan Duggal, what would be your closing comment for today's debate?
Number one, we require a dedicated legislation on cybercrime. Number two, we come up with deterrent punishments, because today in India, a majority of cybercrimes are bailable offences, so there's no deterrence. And number three, we need to come up with strong legal provisions for the purposes of providing appropriate presumptions in the context of production and proof of electronic evidence.
Okay,
because that's
okay,
one key taken. Area where we are lacking, and we need to concentrate.
Okay, point taken. Dinesh Yadav, give us your closing comment, and please answer Surbhi from Itawa, who asked a question of rising cyber crimes.
I'm adding with the Pawan Duggal sir's remark.
Yes.
Okay. By one, two more things I want to add.
Yes.
One thing is the LEAs, the police, they should be proper training for the police to deal with the cyber crimes, because the evidence collected in these crimes are digital,
yes,
form, and they need skill,
yes,
as well as special tools.
Yes.
Number two,
yes,
the judicial officers and prosecutors,
yes,
they also need to be trained in cyber handling the cyber crime evidences.
So that's an important point. I take
as
that
far as the girl from it up,
judicial officers, anyways, yeah, you close, please give your closing. Yes.
As far as the cyber crimes are increasing,
yes,
cyber crimes are increasing, they are much more, the reporting is basically now these crimes are being registered.
Okay
till if you see the number, in my experience, the number will be more. I think at least 10 times than the registered.
Okay.
Most of
okay.
the social
okay.
media crimes, the girls say, we don't want to register the crime, kindly. Okay.
Okay. Thank you so much, Dinesh Yadav, Pawan Duggal, VK Suri, for sharing your thoughts on this issue. We will continue to track these cases as well as take up this issue time and again. Thank you so much for joining us on Current Issues discussion on cybercrime in India today. Thank you.